Alright guys, welcome back to Let's Play The Legend of Heroes, Trails of Cold Steel 2. Last time left off, we managed to apprehend Duke Albarea, and before that Sarah had her little moment with the Yeagers. Speaking of Sarah, that she is right over here. And we get to keep all of the equipment that she equipped beforehand. That's nice of you, game. And today we are going to do the bonding events. This is actually the last free day of the game where we get to spend bonding points. I just finished reading the latest volume of this popular series. Hopefully the next one will come out soon. Would you like to give it a read? I'm sure you will see right away why it is so popular. And there we get chapter 12. And if we talk to Giolamo, there is actually a dessert that goes perfectly with our espresso. Colette is a big fan of them. She claims just one bite can fill you with bliss. Why don't you try it for yourself? And here we get the fruit parfait. And once again, for some reason, the game decided to give them out of order. Oh well, we can get this one later on. Hey there, Sarah.
Hey there, Rin.
Oh, hi there, instructor. Are you feeling a little better now?
Feeling just fine, thank you very much. Though I might have overdone it a bit against those guys. Still, at least I was able to see you kids off like a good teacher should. No regrets there.
Instructor.
Come on, don't give me that look. I might be here resting, but you look like you should get some rest yourself.
She always dodges having to tell us much about her past, but she might actually be making an exception this time. Would you mind if I stayed here and rested a bit with you? I would even be happy to join you for a drink or something. Water, I guess.
Really? You're gonna be rolling into bars, chatting up ladies like a pro soon, with the way you are going. Just take a seat there, I will get you something fancier than water on me. Phew, this hard liquor is fighting back, gotta pace myself better. Can't chug 'em cause you're too strong. I'm three sheets to the wind before I know it. It's better than nothing, but I will take a good beer or cider any day.
I'm struggling with this cocktail personally. Feels like I will get drunk from it even though there is no alcohol in it.
Well hey, that's just one part of the appeal of drinking. I will make sure to teach you how to savor it once you are old enough. Same way both my superior and my friend did, back for me, in the day.
Was that back when you were a part of the Northern Yeagers?
Yup. Granted, they both kicked the bucket a long time ago.
Sorry about that.
This operation brought back a lot of memories. Some of them bad, but plenty of good ones too. Getting my back there was a real struggle. Felt like no matter what I did, nothing ever got any better.
You came from Northumbria, didn't you? Seems like life there was a lot more brutal than I could have ever imagined. Would you mind if I asked just when you decided to join the Corps?
I couldn't tell you exactly when. It felt like as soon as I knew what was going on around me, I had a gun in my hands. Not like there was much else you could do to earn a living around there. They say it was a nice place till the Northumbrian disaster struck around 20 or so years ago. I only go back once every few years now, mainly to pay my respects.
I see.
It was the kind of place where death would follow you wherever you went. Really? And I wasn't any exception to that. I have lost many people who were important to me. One day they were there, the next they were gone. It wasn't until around 6 years ago that Beatrix, well, Colonel Beatrix back then, saved me. After that, I cut all my ties and headed down to the path of becoming a bracer. You all know the rest after that.
I guess we do. I don't even know what to say. I can't imagine leading a life like that.
Yes, indeed. You won't find many heroines as tragic as me. But well, what happened at Aurochs Fort made me realize something. Turns out I hadn't completely cut my ties to that place. Crossing blades with my old comrades was more painful than I expected.
Maybe it's selfish of me to say, but I wish it weren't.
Guess this just shows that I have still got a long way to go as an instructor. There is still so much I want to teach you, so you can make it through all of this, but I probably wasn't cut out for the job to begin with, you know?
I have to respectfully disagree with you there, instructor. We have learned a lot from you, both individually, as a class. Things that you didn't specifically try to teach us either. We learned those simply through observing your actions.
Like what?
Like what happened at Aurochs Fort. Your actions taught us that fighting for the people and country you love can be painful at times. We saw that in your willingness to cross blades with those you once knew. You showed us what it means to be truly determined, at least, that's what I got out from it. And I'm certain we will one day have to show that very same determination. That is why we would like you to continue teaching us from here on out. In fact, we need you to. I can't see us taking back tours without your experience and guidance, let alone getting through to Crow.
Wow, look at you, Rin. The teachers become the student. Talk about cliches. I get it though. If you are that insistent, then I will make sure you all get the best education possible. As your instructor, and as your comrade.
We will probably get a bonding event in Cold Steel 3 where they actually get to drink. I can't wait to see it. And speaking of Colette, she's right up here.
How is it going, Rin?
Not bad. You're looking cheerful, Colette. And packing up too, does that mean that what I think it means?
Yep, it's time for me to jump on board and help you guys out. Just finishing up sorting everything out right now.
Thank you, Colette. We are more than glad to have you helping us out.
Thing is though, I don't exactly see all the sorting out I have to do being done by the time you all take off. It would be rude to fly off without saying goodbye to everyone too. Would you mind picking me up next time you stop by Breahard?
Not at all. Gives me the time to meet up with everyone else too. Alright, well, guess we have to come back for you later. Let's see, Fee should be around here somewhere. There she is. Fee, what's going on? Why are you sitting here wearing only one sock?
The sole of one of my boots came off while I was walking, and now my foot kinda hurts. So I'm taking a break.
Well, after all those boots have been through, I can't really blame them for giving up the ghost like that. Is your foot gonna be okay?
Once I have rested a bit, sure. I will get the boots fixed up after that. You can just keep walking.
Wait, how does she think she's gonna get to that tailor without footwear. She's just going to roll down this hill. While that might be fun to watch, might as well help her out. Okay, foot is feeling better now. Off we go. Hold up, Fee. You are not actually planning on walking there with your foot like that, are you? Might as well. I'm used to this kind of stuff anyway. Well, maybe so. But you still shouldn't be walking around on it like that. What if you stepped into something sharp on the way? What do you want me to do then? Guess I will have to be the gallant knight here. Here we go. What's up? Did this start hurting again?
I'm fine. Just kinda amazed, really. Didn't think anyone else would have offered a piggyback ride in that situation.
Huh?
Don't worry about it. Into the store we go, my steed.
Sorry, but the Pony Express stops here. That scene will always remind me of the picture where someone swapped out Fee with Osborne. Upon reaching the tailor, Irene asked to fix up Fee's shoes for her. They were told it would be a quick process, so they had a look around the store in the meantime. Oh hey, they have got Stregas here. You're pretty fond of this brand, aren't you?
Sure am. Seems like they have only got formal wear here though. I would have been up to buying some new sneakers, if they had any.
I don't see you prancing around in formal wear anyway, to be honest. How long have you been a fan? Since you were in Zephyr?
Yep, the boss brought me a pair for helping out with something. That was the second present he gave me, in fact.
Oh, what was the first then?
The name Clausel. That's a present I will never let go of, either. There is no one else in the world who can give me that, after all.
I know how you feel. Dad welcoming me as a proper member of the Schwarzer family meant the world to me. So yeah, let's keep our appreciation for that close to our hearts.
Speaking of things from the past, I was actually reminded of the boss when you were giving me that piggyback ride.
Huh?
He did the same for me not long after, bringing me into Zephyr. Stuff like that's what made him feel like he actually was my real dad.
He?
There is something else I realized too. You remind me of the boss, but you are not actually him in the end. Just like Class 7 is in the same family that Zephyr was, even though both are important to me. I am not the same person I was back then, either. I don't want to sit around and be protected all the time anymore.
Yeah, that is right. We are all in this together, Fee. Supporting each other's the obvious way to go.
Yep. And I'm gonna use what I learned from my old family to do just that. Thank you, Rin.
Not at all. It took a little more time before their order was ready, so the two wandered the store for a while longer. Once it was, they saw that Fee's shoes were as good as new. And there we go, that's a character note update for Fee. One thing I didn't mention really about the bonding events is that we actually can get all the character notes in one go this time around, unlike in the first game where you basically had to play through it twice if you wanted all the character notes. Anyway, now we can buy the crystal dress and crystal heels and the platinum equipment for the men. But I'm not gonna bother with it just yet. Let's see, we did two girls, let's do two guys now. Where is everyone anyway? Like, most of them are in the station street. Might as well do Elliot. I wonder what's going to happen to Keldic now. Sure, Yukabari has been dealt with, but that's not going to heal the sadness in their hearts. And apprehending his own dad isn't exactly going to cheer Yusis up either. He seems pretty down. I wonder if I can do something to cheer him up. I have got an idea. Hey, Elliot. What do you say we head over to that restaurant in the central plaza? Which one? The one Yusis's uncle runs. I think it might just cheer you up for a bit. Deciding that this was the best way to cheer him up, Dean brought Elliot to the Sorcier restaurant. Once there, they received special permission from Yusis's uncle to go up to the VIP floor. What a beautiful melody. That pianist's been in several music magazines, you know. Oh, so she's famous. That would explain how her music manages to resonate so well. Only the pros can manage that. Of course, the same goes for you too, Elliot. What? No way. Just hearing her play makes me realize that I have still got a long way to go. The world of music really is deep. Your mom was a pianist too, wasn't she? Yeah. I remember how she used to play all sort of stuff for us. She had always played something fun and light-hearted for me and Fiona whenever we were down. It worked like a charm, always cheered us right up. I bet she did the same for Dad too. Thank you, Rin. I can't say why you brought me here now. You wanted to remind me that music has the power to inspire, help people move on, right? Guilty. It's just a shame that I couldn't do it with my own performance, really. That would have been cool. Sorry for sucking. Don't be so hard on yourself, Rin. In fact, you have helped me realize that there is still something I can do for the people of Keldic. Now I just need time and an ideal opportunity. Give us a shout when that time comes, okay? We will gladly help you out. Right, I think it's about time I had a go at it myself. Listening is nice, but nothing beats actually playing. Works for me. He will actually have a side quest next act that involves music and Keldic, but we will get to it. Knowing Elliot wouldn't back down after setting his heart on playing, Rin asked Hammond and the pianist for permission. Fortunately, they were more than happy to agree, and everyone in the restaurant was soon able to enjoy a special performance from him. Unsurprisingly, he played on par with the pianist before him. Both Rin and the customers couldn't help but be fully entranced by the wonderful sound of his music. Alright, that takes care of Elliot. Let's see, who to do next? Actually, might as well talk to Yusis's uncle since we are here. Welcome. Are you planning on resting today?
I can only imagine how exhausted you must be after all that has happened. Allow me to be so bold as to request that you all stay by Lord Eustace's side as much as possible as well. While they were never on good terms, having to arrest his own father must have hurt him more than he is letting on. We would be honored, sir. Alright, I guess I might as well do Eustace later this episode. But first, let's do Lakias, why not? Where are you, buddy? Ah, here you are. Eustace's recent actions have made me think. If my father stepped from the path of righteousness, would I be able to do the same thing as Eustace did? Would you? I don't even want to think about it. It couldn't have been easy for him, of course. But it takes a lot of strength to stand up to your father like that. But I'm sure having our support is helping him make it through. He might not say it, but I think he appreciates us being here. You might be right. Aside from our support helping him, he's so full of himself that he's bound to recover once his ego reinflates itself. And on that note, I have shopping to do. Wouldn't want to show too much compassion, would we, Machias? What could he be here to buy, though? What are you here to buy, anyway? Flowers for some special occasion? That's one way to put it. Actually, while you are here, mind helping me choose? I think it would make him happier if you did. Together, Rin and Machias made their choice and walked to the Nordkreuzen Highway. This is Saar Bridge, right? Is there a reason you brought that bouquet, Machias? It's my way of paying respect. This lake flows towards Keldic, so I guess here will do. It's for the market manager, isn't it? Well, yes, I owe him a lot, after all. It's because of him that we were able to avoid being noticed by the provincial army during our time in Keldic. I don't think Class 7 ever would have been reunited if it weren't for his help. It's frustrating, knowing that we will never be able to pay him back. This is the least I can do for him. Machias. It was the anniversary of my cousin's death the other day too, but I wasn't able to visit her grave. I couldn't with how things are at the moment, but it's the least I can do for her too. Oh, was it? What exactly are you planning to do with the bouquet? Gaius taught me about the Nord way of paying respect to the dead that I wanted to try. They say that by sending a bouquet down a river, your feelings will reach those that have departed. This is my way of swearing an oath to both of them. That we will make it through this war, no matter what. And that I will work toward turning Rebonia into a country where the innocent have no need to suffer anymore. If only. Changing an entire country sounds impossible, but... You know what, Machias? Part of me feels like we could pull it off. If we can make it through this, there is no limit to what we can do, to what we can change. You really think so? I am glad you feel the same as I do. That's a nice gesture. I'm sure your cousin and the market manager are watching over us too. So, let's make sure not to disappoint them. I wouldn't dream of it. Watch me, you two. With Class 7 by my side, I will make sure to fulfill this vow I have given. Dean and Makia stood in respectful silence as they watched the bouquet float into the distance. Once it was completely out of the view, they walked back to Bereahard. And that's another character note for Makias this time around. We will need 90 of those, I think, for a special reward from Halfin. And we are getting there, slowly but surely. Alright, might as well drop by the Albarea household and see how things are faring over there. The size of this place never ceases to amaze me. Both the Duke and Scarlet are being held here, I think.
Damn, this is incredible. It's not as grand as Valflame Palace, but I doubt you'll find many mansions this fancy. The Duke's residence is certainly befitting of his status.
You came after all, Reen.
Yeah, I was kinda hesitant to come and visit in case I got in your way, though.
No, it's fine. Everything is largely settled here now. I will leave the rest to you, then.
As you wish. Leave everything to us, and we will strive and make things as comfortable for your father as possible.
You have my thanks.
He's Captain Clare's adjutant, isn't he?
Indeed, and quite a skilled one at that. He and his men will be managing the mansion together while keeping my father in custody. At least until the war comes to an end.
Oh, right.
There's no need to look so glum. He deserves to answer for his crimes much like others. He should be grateful he hasn't been handcuffed and thrown in a cell.
I guess that's one way of looking at it. Oh, yeah, Scarlet's here too, right?
She's currently receiving treatment in the annex. She remains bedridden, but her life is in no real danger, or so I hear.
That's good.
If you'd like to speak with her, you should go and pay her a visit. Meanwhile, I'll be going to my room to get ready for departure. If you need anything at all, feel free to come by and see me.
Thanks, Eustace. Will do. Wait a sec. Where is his room anyway? I don't know where the Annex Scarlet's Inn is either. I guess I'll have to ask someone.
Or we could just follow the red exclamation mark. Yeah, that works better. And after that we can visit Eustace, I guess. Since he does have a bonding event. Pretty fancy place. I guess this is what one of the four great houses' mansions looks like. No surprise there.
Oh.
I knew it would be you. Did you come to listen to me whine and complain about you?
I know you didn't want me to save you, but you don't have to hate me for it.
I was just joking. I don't care what happens to me. Whether I live or die or get executed as a terrorist, what happens, happens.
Stop being so flippant about the whole thing. But you seem to be a little more cheerful than I was expecting you to be. I'm glad. Well, it sounds like you're doing all right at least. That's good.
My only complaint is that I wasn't allowed to ascend to heaven like I wanted to. But perhaps this is just how it was meant to be.
I wish I could tell you. You said you used to be a sister, right? You mentioned something about training over in Artaria, too.
I did. Though that training was a long time ago. That really takes me back.
So that wasn't a lie? Sorry. It wasn't that I didn't believe you, it's just...
I'll have you know I grew up in one of the most pious families in the country. Hard as that may be to believe. I was so, so happy when I was first invited to join the church. I doubt you'd know, but the church is a fairly complex organization with plenty of divisions within it. The part I was invited to join was an organization called the Congregation for the Sacraments. They're a group full of immensely skilled people who take on some unique missions, to put it mildly. It made me happier than you can imagine to be recognized by people like that at such a young age. I didn't have any special abilities of my own, but I left home, trained my hardest, and eventually became a squire.
A squire? As in a kind of knight? I thought you said you became a sister. Unless you're saying the church has knights too. Ugh, I'm getting confused now.
Anyone would be in your position. Their image of the church begins and ends with priests and mass. As it was, my days in Artaria came to an abrupt end. Just before I went out on my first mission, I got word of what had happened. I hurried back to Erebonia as fast as I could. But I was too late to do anything.
Lady Scarlet, I think you should get some more rest.
Sorry, I didn't mean to make you strain yourself.
You really are a softie. If you want to hear the rest, you'll have to come back another time. So, if you're interested...
It's hard to imagine someone going from being a sister to a terrorist, but that's just what happened. I'm still convinced that it would have been a waste for her to have died back there. I'm glad she seems to have calmed down for now. I'll have to come back another time to see how she's doing.
Man, there is still a lot of information that Rin has no clue about, huh? Like the whole church business. Guess we will have to piece those together one at a time in Cold Steel. Might as well head to Yosis's room. Let's see, there should be here it is. And here we get the windy coloring. Gaius should like that. Hey there, Yosis. The RMP should be able to take care of the mansion for the time being. Perhaps this is a chance for me to take one of the horses out for a final ride before I leave. That sounds kind of fun, actually. Mind if I join you, Yosis? I haven't even seen any of your family's horses since that race we had. Not at all. That gives me an idea, in fact. Come with me. Where? Please don't make me carry any more bags. Norin, today you will be carrying the horses. But... Rin borrowed one of the horses from the Albarea mansion, while Yosis rode another. Together, they set off on a horseback towards Orok's Canyon, with Yosis taking a lead. Huh, this is where we had our duel before, isn't it? Why did we come out here? Draw your sword, Rin. I would like to request another duel with you. Yosis.
Do you remember what you told me during our field study here? You claimed that there was something honest about the way I fought. And that it was because I learned my swordsmanship from someone I trusted. I did, didn't I? My trust in my brother has not faltered. However, because of that trust, I fear that when the time comes to fight him, my sword will be hindered by hesitation. I dread the day that I will have to turn my blade upon my own brother. I am not proud of it, but that is how it is. I can hardly blame you, Eusis. Anyone in your position would feel the same way. Perhaps, but that is why I would like to face off with you, Rin. Whether I win or lose, I believe her duel will allow me to cast away any doubt. And through that, I should be able to better trust in my own convictions, regardless of whom I may face. I realize that this is somewhat selfish of a request, but please, this is important to me. Am I even allowed to say no after that speech? It is not often that you ask for a favor like this, either. Sure, let's go. Just know that I won't be holding back. Hit me with all you have got. With pleasure. Thus, Rin and Eusis began their duel, putting all of their strength into the battle. They cleared their heads of all distractions, their focus purely on trying to be the victor. With that, the fight continued on until... I don't think I can move another muscle. Neither can I. Even in real battles, it is not often that I fight to the point of exhaustion. I think it's because we can read each other so well that we were able to fight to this point, really. Granted, I could see Master Kafai and Viscount Arsed keeping it up the whole day, not getting tired or bored. We are not them, but I still think we did pretty well for a couple of teenagers. Agreed, it was fun in our own strange way. Thank you, Rin. I feel as though I can now go forth and fight with the same honesty yet again. I may have been taught by Rufus, but it was Class 7 who helped me to further develop my skills. No need to thank me. I'm just glad you were honest with me and asked. That was beyond awful. It's not often that we see Eusis laugh out loud like that. Afterward, they somehow managed to summon up the energy to get on their horses and return to Bareahard. Alright, I think I have time for one more event. And well, Emma is in her lonesome right over here, and her event isn't that long.
What a peaceful place. It was during our field study, of course, but it is nice to see that that is still the case. This peace could be a recent development, though. These past few weeks might not have been so kind. They certainly haven't been too kind to you, sis. Still, there is not much we can do now, except rest and recover, and we need it.
This does seem like a nice enough place to rest, to be honest. Hey, would you mind if I sat with you for a while? Not to steal your idea or anything, but this does seem like a nice spot to take a break.
I certainly thought so. Please, Make yourself comfortable. It's nice and quiet here, not too cold either. Don't think I have been able to sit back and relax like this in a long time. My eyes feel so heavy, must be more tired than I thought. Well, we did just fight Yusis, so... Rin? Looks like he fell asleep. I guess I shouldn't be surprised. He must be exhausted after Arlok's fort. In that case... I must have fallen asleep. On something nice and comfy, no less. Hello there, sleepyhead. Emma. Whoa! Took you long enough to realize. Emma, why was I on your lap?
Did you sleep well?
Best sleep of my life. Don't change the subject. Well, let me apologize. I really didn't expect to end up sleeping on your lap like that.
I'm the one who put you there in the first place, so no need to think about apologizing. I couldn't leave you to sleep on a cold, hard bench, after all. One of my duties as a witch is to support you. Just think of this as another form of support.
That's kind of a stretch.
I would have appreciated if you let me do this much for you, at least. It is all thanks to both you and Valimar that Bereahard has regained peace. In fact, I believe we have managed to come as far as we have, thanks to your efforts.
I don't know about that, Emma. You are forgetting that I had all of you. I have been able to push myself through all this, only thanks to the people who chose to stick by me. Besides, I never would have come across Valimar in the first place if it weren't for your guidance.
You think that much of us, Rin?
Well, yeah. We have still got a long road ahead of us, right? That road will eventually lead us to Crow and Vita. So, sorry, but you are still stuck with us, Emma. We need your support, now more than ever.
I can live with that. I will do everything in my power to help, both as your friend and as your class president.
And Emma is the first person to reach level 6. I guess that hot spring scene really did help out a lot. Oh well, I will get other people there sooner or later, although I don't think anyone else will reach level 6 this time around. But we will get a lot of bonding points later on anyway. But what are Gaius, Elisa, Toa, Milium, Laura, and Alfin, I think that's everyone, up to in Bereahard? Find out next time on Let's Play The Legend of Heroes, Trails of Cold Steel 2. Thank you guys for tuning in. Until then, have a good one.